a Google WW and an upcoming three intern at Microsoft. So the reason why I picked this particular topic to optimize a GitHub profile with an attractive profile really is because that being a designer myself, I really, really, really add to the visual appeal of everything that is involved, you know, around us and whatever that we are doing. So that's just about the gist of it. And why am I going to be teaching you about this? So as the message was floated, you might have looked at my GitHub profile. I made some little changes here and there to it. So you can, you know, it's a little modified now from what you saw before, because I was trying different things. But yeah, so the expectations you can have from this session is that you'll be able to create your README profile really, really well. You will be able to add two advanced features. So the two advanced features that we're going to be talking about are, one, you will be able to add a feature to your README where it will display which song you are listening to on Spotify at the current moment. So that's something. The second advanced feature is that we're going to be using GitHub Actions to add a feature wherein the tweets that you are posting, they will be displayed straight on your profile README. So it's when I say advanced, it's not really advanced, but like if you go into the concept advanced, however, I will make it fairly simple for you. So I also have blog list and everything ready. So you won't have to, you know, think a lot about it. But yeah, that's just about it. Now, before we begin, I want a no in the chat, not a yes, a no in the chat from those who have never discovered that how they can go on their GitHub profiles and create a README for their profile, not for a repository, but for a profile. I just want to know that. Okay. Right, we have a lot of people. Okay, cool. So first of all, I'm going to show you how you need to actually do that. So for those of you who are connected with the laptops right now, do it with me so that it's very easy. So just do it with me. Moving on to the next slide. Okay, so you have to basically create a new repository. Everybody knows how to create a new repository. Go to your GitHub profile and create a new repository right now and put the name of your repository, the exact same name, which is your GitHub username. So like, look at this. So the owner of this repository is Monica. So her username is M0NICA. So the repository name will be the exact same name as that of the owner. So do this quickly, you know, make it public and initialize it with the README. So you can see that you found a secret. It's a special repository that you can use to add a README to your GitHub profile. Make sure it's public and initialize it with the README to get started. So you have to initialize it with the README and keep it public. The repository name should be the exact same name as that of your GitHub username. Do that. It should take under 1 minute. After you've done creating the new repository, just like put a yes in the chat. It'll create a template. It'll give you a template, the starter template. You don't have to write anything in it. Just create this repository for now. Yes, you have to click on add a README. So you have to initialize it with README. Okay, I'll wait till 4:11. So till 4:11, it's fairly simple. You don't have to add anything to your README right now. You don't have to make any comments or something. You just have to do this so that you have a template, you have a, you know, a boilerplate in which you can add it later. So it's for Charvi and for everybody who already have a profile README, but they want to update it. So for you, what you guys can do is, let me just go to my, I'll show that. So for those who already have a README, just click here. So this is this small pencil button. This is the edit button. So when you'll click on edit, you'll end up here. So this becomes, you know, this is how you can edit your README if you've already initialized it. Okay. One more minute and then we'll move forward to the other thing. I see a lot of people doing it. Okay, yeah, it's 4:11. So we'll move on to the next thing. So the first thing that I really, really liked was to add into your GitHub repository. This is Jessica Lim's profile README screenshot. So the word clause that she has added is her favorite quarantine pastime, but you can add something that resonates with you. So I found this website, which is called thewordclause.com. I'll just like take you to this website. So this website has like pretty amazing features. So what you can do is that, let it just render a little. So as you can see that, here is a t-shirt, right? And you can change the shape of this. So let's say that you resonate with something. Let's say I resonate with cats or dogs or something. So I might want to use that feature. Let's say this is a half cookie, right? So like my team name is always Celestial Biscuits. So I like cookies a lot. So well, let's say this is a cookie. So now you can add your words here. So this word list can be importing from CSV, or you can, edit it here. So this word cloud you can create, which can just like add a little fun element to your GitHub README profile. So this is the first thing that, you can add. And adding an image is again fairly simple. It's just how you add images to your markdown. So if you want, I can send the syntax for it in the end. But this is something that I really liked. So this is the first fun feature. Moving on, so next we have the fun badges, like you see, these badges, then GitHub statistics, then build with science, makes people smile, contains cat gifs, and a lot more. So these are the two links I'll be sharing this presentation toward the end of the session, obviously. So I'll show you how the badges work. So let's go to for the badge first. So for the badge has a lot of, different things like powered by electricity, gluten-free, and built with love, uses HTML, contains cat gifs, and so on. So these are some of the, again, some more fun badges that you can take. You can start, you can click on view all. And I also saw that there was this one thing, it works on my machine. I used to put it on my website. Not my website, my README profile. A little like not a work feature, homemade pizza rolls and stuff like that. So yeah, this is a really fun thing. Yeah, okay, here is it. Works on my machine. So you can add this particular thing to not just your profile readmes, but also to your different project readmes, like it works on your machine. So moving on to the next thing. So this repository, it's basically a list of all the badges in Markdown. However, I'm just going to show you this one thing. It's called the GitHub hits, wherein you can see the hit count. It's not giving right now, but GitHub profile where you can just see that how many things are here, the multi-language rainbow languages. I mean, like it just says that you use a lot of languages, the number of stars, the number of issues, the number of repos, followers, pull requests, then your GitHub statistics. So I'll just tell you how to actually do this. So you see that this is the entire syntax. This is what you have to put in your README. Okay, let me just open something where I can tell you how to just edit it. Okay, let's just say that, let me just take it from here, where the username has been written to your username. That's all you have to do. And adding this to your README will directly make, it's going to click over here, Twitter RSS feed. So when you click on the Twitter RSS feed, you have to enter Twitter URL, which is nothing but twitter.com/your username, your Twitter username. If you don't remember your username, you can just go and copy and then click on generate. After you're done, write a yes in the chat. Click on, I'll just like repeat it once again. So you have to click on new feed. Okay. And you're here, create new feed. You have to click on Twitter RSS feed. And then enter a URL, twitter.com/your username. Okay, I see a very few responses for those who have done it. Like if you'll do it with me, obviously like you'll not have to work on it later or just like see the recordings or something. I'm not going to take a lot of your time, so I'll just like urge you to do it, because like obviously this webinar has not been organized for 10 people. It has been organized for each one of you. if we don't have a Twitter account, so can we go for Insta? Vedangini, so what will happen is the RSS feed doesn't exactly extract your images. Okay, so if even if you take Instagram, it's going to give you some bizarre output. So putting Instagram feed on a GitHub profile doesn't look very fine. So if you don't have Twitter, then you can probably wait for this particular step. You can continue with me for the Spotify step. Okay. Right. Fine. So now what we're going to do is that I'm going to tell you how to add it. Okay. So like you have your RSS app. It's going to be my feeds. Okay. So after you're done generating your feed, it'll give you a link over here. All right. So now what you have to do is that you have to go here and then go to your repositories. Right. So you see that in my particular repository, so my repository's name is again, I'm like again saying it because it's obviously a README. So the repository's name is this exactly same as my username. How you can end up here is you can click here and come to this, or what you can do is you can just add it in your address bar, github.com, right? Not GitHub, GitHub. github.com/yourusername1, then /, and then your username. So that's how you'll end up inside the repository. GitHub desktop, whatever you want. We are not going to be doing this particular step right now. Just watch very closely. I'll be repeating it twice so you don't have any doubts or something. So what you have to do is after you are done cloning it, you'll open it in your favorite editor. It can be VS Code or Atom or whatever. So you have to create a folder. Like I'll just tell you the folder structure right here. Okay. So there is going to be a folder with the name of .github. Okay. First, there's going to be a folder of .github. And inside that folder, there is going to be another folder which is named workflows. Okay. After you're done creating these two folders, again, I'm repeating again. So after you're done cloning or using the GitHub desktop to open your particular repositories, you'll go into the .github folder, create it because it is not available by default. You have to create it. Then create a subfolder named workflows, and then you have to create a .yml file. Now you can add this as Twitter workflow or whatever name you want to. So in this Twitter workflow, in this Twitter workflow YML file, what you have to do is that the blog link that I have added in the presentation. So this is the blog link. Here you'll get the code, the one which you have to paste. The change that you have to make here is where did it go? Yeah, it's here. Okay. The change you have to make is this feed list. So this feed list is going to be coming from here. The RSS feed that you generated, this link is going to be pasted in this particular file in front of the key named feed list. Is that clear? If that's clear, please write a yes in the chat. Did you follow it? Because I'm going to obviously go through it once again, but I just need to know if you followed it. Right. Cool. So I'm explaining it once again. So what you have to do is you have to go github.com. Again, I'm just like very bad at typing, I guess. /your username/again your username. So you end up on the repository where your README is contained. Then you have to create a new folder named .github. In that folder, you have to create a new subfolder named workflows. In that folder, you have to create a file named twitter-workflow.yml file. So this is the GitHub action that you are creating. We're not going to be going into the conceptual understanding of what GitHub actions are and how do they work. But for now, let's assume that this is a file which is going to be supporting your Twitter tweets edition. Okay. So in this YML file, copy the code from here, from the blog by Stephen Jenkins. So you'll be using this code. Then the change that you will be making is this feed list. You will be changing the value for the feed list key. Where this value is going to come from is from the RSS feed that you generated. Okay. So I hope that's clear. Now your entire settings are done. How do you actually run it now? So I had a few yeses in the chat. Now for those, do we have to make a folder in GitHub or in VS Code? So like Harshtai said that when you will be done cloning it, then whichever editor that you will be using, you'll have to make a folder in that only. Okay. Yeah, so where was I? So I see like a few five, six people saying yes to it. That, you know, we understood it. Now, I need at least half of you to understand it, or else like I won't move to the next part. So the ones who did not say yes yet, or the ones who did not understand it, how we are doing it, please like let me know so that I can go over it once again, if that's required. File name inside the GitHub folder. This is the directory structure. So it's, let me just zoom in a bit. So it's .github, then a folder named workflows, then the file, Twitter workflow. You can follow this along using the blog only. So again, like it's there, but I am explaining it once again so that, you know, there is no confusion. Any doubts, anybody? Cool. I'll just like assume that you have done it. So now how do you actually run it? So how does this, is this going to work? So what happens is that since like we are using a free account, so you won't be able to actually, dynamically get that. But how we're going to do is that you go to this actions part. Okay, let me just. So the workflow that you see is this latest Twitter tweets. Okay, then you have to click on run workflow. When you'll click on run workflow, let me just see. So it'll run a new workflow, and then, you know, it has already run it. So you can see that it will show you the time and the time taken to run it. So that's how you can do it. Again, reiterating it, go to actions. Then what workflows do you have? You have latest Twitter tweets. Then run workflow and click on run workflow. That's all you have to do. And after this is done, I'll just like show you what is shown in the README. So this is going to be shown in your README. The latest tweets that you'll have is, I said the thank you Tech Phantoms for this. And I wanted exactly this was like, this is some prize that they sent. So this is going to be basically a link. And this link will be, your RSS feeding. Again, this is a free account. That is why it's going to obviously advertise it a little. But after the time is done, so then you go directly to the YouTube, not YouTube, to the tweet that was there in question. So this is how you'll see the tweets. I hope that's fine. Running the actions is fine. Seeing how the tweets will be presented and how you can go to those tweets, that's fine. Put a yes in the chat, please. Bhanu, you want to do it with me? Okay, sure. I'll do that. There you go. It's going to take 5-6 minutes for you to integrate it. So what we can do is that after we're done iterating over all the things that I have for you today, so we can, I'm going to stay here. So I'll help you with the doubts and everything that you might have. So I've sent the blog link, but that's how we're going to do it. So yeah. So it'll parse the latest 5 tweets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So yeah, that's what's going to happen. Put a yes in the chat if that's clear, everybody. So like if you have any doubts, I do not expect you to like understand it like completely, but still like if you have anything you want to ask me, just shoot it. If you don't want to ask me anything, just put a yes in the chat so that we can move on to the next part. Got it. Nice. So next we are going to be doing, I'll just like escape the full screen because I don't want to see the full screen. So yeah, we'll be doing the Spotify thing. Like you will be doing it with me. Okay. So before we do this, I just want you guys to like let me know if you have created your readmes. Like it's just there. By creating a readmes, I just mean that even if it's a template, like you don't have anything written in it, or it's just like this is my name or anything. I just want to know that you have your profile ready. Okay, cool. So we're going to be following this. I'm sending this link in the chat. So this you have to obviously follow along with me. This might be a little tricky for you to do. I'll just close this out. So this is the link that we have to go at. So what you have to do is you have to fork this. So the first step is forking this repository. When you're done forking it, let me know. I had already forked it, so I'll just like open that particular repository. It's going to look something like this after you forked it. There is going to be a fork, then your name, and then the repository's name forked from this particular repository. Is that there? Are you done with it? Have you forked the repository? Okay. Okay, I'll just like repeat it once again. So you have to, the repository link that I sent in the chat, you have to go to that and click on fork. So here is fork on the top right corner. So you have to click on fork, and then a repository will be created, something like this, where your username will be there and then /, the name of the repository. Is that fine? Should we move ahead? Everybody has forked? I'm getting very few responses. Like, I don't know why. I worked so hard for this. Don't do that. Okay, cool. So, cool. Shishi, do you have to tell me something? Okay, no, Shishi doesn't have to tell me anything. Cool, we'll move forward. Then when you have forked the repository, open up this file. It's called setup.md. So this has the entire things that you have to do, but still, like, if you're a complete beginner, you'll have to do it with me, or else you won't be able to understand exactly kya karna hai. So has everybody found the setup file and opened it? Please put a yes in the chat. Okay, so you have found the set. So the first step is to create a Spotify application. So you have to open this link, open it in a new tab. Right. So it will take you to the developer.spotify login. So you can log in or like create an account, whatever. Do that. Log in into your dashboard. If you have logged in, just put an L or something, because it will get mixed with the previous S's. Yeses, sorry. So put in or L or whatever you want to, if you have logged in to Spotify. Okay, 2 people, 3 people. I'll wait for 2 more minutes. We have a lot of time. No worries. So I'll give you one more minute. 4:36. I'll be like telling you the next step. So you have to log in to your Spotify account, Spotify for Developers Portal. Okay, after forking, Dipali, what you have to do is you have to go to this setup.md file. You'll find it here. So here is setup.md file. Just open it in a new tab. Okay, and when you'll open it, so you see there is a setup guide which will basically walk you through how you have to set up the particular Spotify thing into your README. So you'll have to create a Spotify application. So you when you like open this, it will take you to the developer portal of Spotify. I'm already logged in, but you have to log in. So that's what you have to do. After forking, you have to open the setup.md file and log into your dashboard, Spotify dashboard. Okay. It's 4:36. So let's just move on to the next steps. So what you have to do now is create an app. So you'll create an app, give it a name. Let's say you call it Profile README, Spotify integration. You can give it any name your wish. You have to obviously compulsorily add an app description. I'll just say it's a Spotify integration for Profile README. Okay. Then you click on I understand and create the application. If you've created the application, write a C in the chat, please. Okay. I'll wait for some more seconds because only 5 people have done that. Nine people. Let's just round it off. One more person. Create the app. Okay. I got three together. Nice. Okay. We have a lot of people. Right. When you're done creating your app, you will get these codes. There is going to be a client ID and a client secret. I am showing this to you guys, but obviously I'll be deleting this later. So you won't be able to use my credentials. You'll have to use your credentials only. So open up Notepad. Just open up Notepad and copy these. So copy your client ID in the Notepad. Okay. And your client secret. Like I'll just. Fire up Notepad and copy these two things in the Notepad. We will be needing these later. Okay. So when you're done copying the client ID and the client secret, you just write copy in the chat, please. I'm beautifying it so that, you know, I take a little more time than you guys so that most of you can do it. Are you done copying? Right. Okay. Copying was not a big task. So I hope that's what's done. Okay. So now what you have to do is take this URL. You will find this URL in the setup.md. Copy this URL, localhost/callback. Copy this URL, go to your dashboard. Ek baar na dekh lo pehle, then do it on your own. So copy this URL, go to your dashboard where your app is open. Click on edit settings and add this URL in the redirect URL section. Iterating it again, not adding this. Copy this from here, go to your dashboard to the application, edit settings, paste the link in the redirect URLs and click on add. So now this URL has been added as the redirect URL for your application. After you're done, write a URL in the chat, please. Just the words URL, not the URL, but just the words URL. Okay. Right. Fine. So now what we have to do is we have to find a code. Okay. What you'll do is you'll copy this. So before you paste it in the address bar, just go to your notepad, paste it over here. Okay. For the people who have a problem, like unka jo link hai, it's going, inside it and you're not able to see the entire link, what you can do is format mein ja ke word wrap on kar do. So you won't have trouble of like maximizing your window every time and you won't have to horizontal scroll it. So that problem will be solved. Format mein word wrap on kar do. Okay. So again, like let's just go back to what I was saying. So you go back to the setup.md file and copy this particular link. So when you'll copy this particular link, paste it in your notepad, you'll see that you have to replace this Spotify client ID with your Spotify client ID. Brackets bhi nahi lagane hai. So first of all, copy this Spotify client ID. Make sure you're not copying any spaces. So copy it. And instead of this Spotify client ID, including the brackets, paste it. All right. After you've done this, write a paste in the chat. Is there anybody who wants me to repeat? Right, I guess not. Cool. Okay, back to my notepad. So what you have to do now is take this entire URL, copy it, and then I'll not be able to do this again. So see this clearly, see this with a little more attention. So you have to paste that entire URL here that has your Spotify client ID replaced, okay? And hit enter. Then it will ask you to provide authorization to the application, to your application. Then click on agree. Okay, so now you'll see that this site can't be reached. This doesn't mean that your app broke or something. Jo hamara kaam tha, the code that we had to get is already here. So copy this URL into your notepad once again. Okay, now we got the code. So what you actually need is this part. Yahan par likha hua hai localhost slash callback, then code is equal to this. So you don't need this aage ka part is equal to or usse pehle ka part, you can remove. So this is the code that you'll require in the further coming section. Okay, when you're done copying the code, when you have discovered the code, write code in the chat, please. After replacing the client ID, you just have to take the entire URL, paste it in the address bar and hit enter. Then you'll get a page wherein it will ask you for authorization. You have to click on agree. And then, the URL in the address bar will be changed. And that will look something like, localhost slash callback slash code equal to. So you are concerned with what is there after code equal to, the entire code that you have to save in your notepad. Okay. Right, again. So we have saved a code. Now what we're going to do is we are going to encode our Spotify client ID and Spotify client secrets into Base64 to encrypt it even more, in an even more enhanced manner so that nobody steals our ID and secret. So, okay, this is the link. Although you'll have this link in the setup.md file only, but still I'll just paste it over here. So this is where you have to go. Now, what you have to do is you have to take your client ID, okay, copy it entirely, no spaces, please. So paste it in the encode chart, then listen to this carefully. You have to add a colon, okay? The colon will also be encoded. So you have to add a colon to it. And then you have to copy the client secret, copy it again, and paste it over here. So now you'll get a base64 string which you have to save. So save this base64 string in your notepad. Base 64. After you've done this, please write 64 in the chat, please. After you've done copying the encoded string, I have to write a 64 in the chat. Right, okay. So the ones who are following it with me right now, do you have Git Bash installed on your systems? I hope you have, because I think Gunjan took a session before this and you might have installed Git Bash on your systems. Do you have Git Bash? Okay. So for those who do not have Git Bash, you will have to do separate installation of either, the curl command handler. So what you can do is that you can probably like see this. I mean, Git Bash ko installation pe laga do, and you can follow this later. Abhi ke liye, for now, just see what I'm doing, because it's fairly easy to follow. Again, wahi hai, copy paste karna, sare instructions nahi pe. You can probably do this after the session. So what you have to do now is, so now you have to run a curl command. Okay, again, copy this link and then paste it in your notepad, because we will do all the work. So now you have put your curl command in here. Then you see that here you have to replace two things. One is the base64 and the other one is code. Okay, we have to replace two things, base64 and code. So first we'll take the base64. Make sure you don't copy any spaces. Then you have to take the code. Again, don't copy any spaces. It's so now this entire command is like copied. Take the entire command. I think I copied one space. Wait. Yeah. Copy this. Open up your Git Bash. Right click and hit paste. You can also use the shift plus insert shortcut, or you can right click and paste it. So after you're done, hit enter. So when you'll enter it, I'll just like maximize this. Okay, it's still small, doesn't make any difference. Wait, not minimize. Yeah, okay. So after you've done this, you'll see like a lot of things getting here. You'll get an access token, then you'll get a token type bearer expires in. Then what you're concerned with is this refresh token. Okay. So what you have to do is copy this entire token, this entire string. Okay, till here. Here is where the entire string ends. Right click and hit copy. So now you have got your refresh token. You don't need the quotation marks. When you're done copying the refresh token, hit write refresh in the chat. You don't need the quotation marks. After you're done copying the refresh token, write a refresh in the chat. It's showing invalid client. Vidangani, if it's showing invalid client, then maybe somewhere while copying the client ID or the client secret, kuch error ho gaya hoga wahan par. Maybe in like adding some, spaces and everything, because when I was also doing it, I copied the wrong thing. So that's why it shows that. However, redo it once again. You'll have to redo from the entire first thing. Like you'll have to delete the app and then create it again. Anisha, right click and paste. So you'll have to do it once again. However, it's okay. You can do it after the session. Just see how am I doing it. Not able to. So only Mehak has done it. Everybody else, are you able to copy the refresh token? Changes to be done in the curl command, right? So this was the curl command that we were concerned about. And then you had to replace two things. One is the base 64. Again, remember, brackets bhi nahi chhodne hai. Base 64 ko you have to replace with the base 64 string that we generated, and code will be replaced by the code that we got from the callback. Okay, so these two things that have to be replaced. Akriti, from where do I have to repeat? Okay, after making changes in the curl command, you just have to open Git bash, hit right click and hit paste. Okay, it just ran the command. I probably copied some, I copied the wrong thing. So that's why it's giving me invalid client right now, because I didn't make any changes to this command. It's just like pasted what I had before and ran it. So don't worry about this, but you have to copy the command that after you've done making changes in the curl command. Just like hit right click, put paste, click paste, and then you'll be able to run the command. After you're done running the command, you'll get something like refresh token. It's here. Okay. So you have to copy the refresh, the string that is after the key refresh token. So you have to copy this entire string and save it in your notepad. You don't have to copy the quotation marks. Is that okay? So I have Soumya and Mehak. Anybody else except Soumya and Mehak who are able to do that? Okay. Cool, I'll just move forward. And then if you have any doubts, you can probably take this up in the end. So now we have everything ready. I'll just remove this because this is not what we need. Yeah, coming back. So now we have saved everything that we need. What we do now is deploy this application. So we'll be deploying the virtual. So you have to virtual and create a new account. My account is already created. So that's something like that. So I'll wait for you guys to create a new account. When you create a new account, please write a yes in the chat. Okay, so now you have to basically connect your repository. My GitHub is already connected with Vercel, but it's going to be fairly simple again. So when you click on new project, so here you have to add a GitHub namespace. So when you click on add GitHub namespace, so it'll ask you, where do you want to install Vercel? So just click on your own name only, your own username only, and then it'll link your GitHub profile to Vercel. So after you've done that, let me know. Bhanu, which part do you want me to repeat? You can't. You just have to create a new Vercel account. After you're done creating a new Vercel, what you have to do is that it will just and make you come to this page, this overview page. Then you click on new project. when I click on new project, so here my name is already showing because it's already connected. For you, it will not show anything. So you have to click on the drop-down menu and add a GitHub namespace. So then adding a GitHub namespace, so where do you want to install yourself on your own repository? I mean, your own, what do you call it? Yeah, it's your own repository, right? So you have to just click on this first thing. These are different organizations that I have, but I installed it here. Cool. So now what we have to do is, so you have to search for the repository. Okay, the repository's name is this, Novatrim. And then you click on import. Okay, search for the repository, click on import. Then what you have to do is, if you want to change the project name, it's completely fine, it's up to you. But what we need to do here is add environment variables. Okay, so everything that we had been saving in the, you know, in our notepad, that's what we're going to be using right now. So as you can see in this MD, you need three environment variables. One is the Spotify refresh token, then Spotify client ID, and then Spotify ID. So refresh token, client ID, and secret ID is what we require. So for the name, we will be adding Spotify. I just like copy paste it only because like we don't want to mess up how they have written it. First, the Spotify refresh token, you add a name and then the refresh token that we obtained. Again, don't copy any spaces. Make sure you're copying it rightly. Then add the value, click on add. Then the next thing is the Spotify client ID. Spotify client ID, it's where is it? Here. Then the client secret. So these three environment variables you have to add. So after you're done adding these three environment variables, please write a yes in the chat. Can you please repeat what we have to do after importing the repository? So Swami, after importing the repository, what you have to do is, if you want, you can change the project name, and then you have to add environment variables here. So environment variables will be in secret ID and refresh token. You will be taking these from the notepad that you have been saving everything in. So that. Also, just like saying, don't share these credentials with anyone ever. I'll be deleting this. That's why I'm like showing you my client ID, secret, and everything. So yeah, after you've done adding all these three environment variables, you can write a yes in the chat that you're done with it. Except refresh ID. Okay, so these three things: secret ID, client ID, and refresh token. So you also have to take care that the names are exactly the same.
मैंने अभी गिट इंस्टॉल किया, मेरा रिफ्रेश आईडी आ गई, मैं भूल गई, लेकिन वो कॉपी कहाँ से करना था बता सकते हो?
हाँ श्योर, लाइक व्हाट यू हैव टू डू टू कॉपी इट इज जस्ट लाइक सिलेक्ट इट, जैसे ये तुम्हारा रिफ्रेश टोकन है,
ओके गॉट
देन सिलेक्ट इट एंड देन राइट क्लिक. Yes, the session is being recorded and is currently live on YouTube as well. So that's why I'm just like running a little fast, or else like it would have been. It's not exactly pretty fast. Like I'm still giving you quite some time to do it. Okay. So now after you've done this, you have to click on deploy. मेरा एक ऑलरेडी डिप्लॉयमेंट चल रहा है फ्रॉम दिस रिपोजिटरी ओनली, सो आई वॉन्ट डिप्लॉय इट, बट यू हैव टू वॉन्ट डिप्लॉय इट, विल टेक अ कपल मिनट्स, सो लाइक बिल्डिंग रनिंग चेक्स एंड असाइनिंग डोमेन्स, सो क्लिक ऑन डिप्लॉय एंड लेट इट रन, सो इट विल टेक 2 मिनट्स, सो आई एम गिविंग यू टाइम टिल 5:05 टू कंप्लीट अ डिप्लॉयमेंट. यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन डिप्लॉय हियर. After you deployed, deployed in the chat. Deployment is the last step. After that, we just have to, you know, copy paste a link somewhere in your README. That's all you have to do. Right, we have one more. So for those who didn't stay till the end, they will probably not get the entire resources and the README profile generator that I was going to be sharing. So congratulations, everybody else. You can also like unmute and ask me if there is something that you want to know. Okay, so like 3 people have done it. I'll just like move on. So after you've deployed it in the overview section, so see that there are different domains that are here. So you can, there are 3 domains that are listed, but you can copy any. So like just copy this domain and paste it here. Like paste it in your notepad that you have been working in. So this is the domain. Okay, so you have your domain ready now. Now, when you go back to the setup.md file, so you see that you can, here is written that you can now use the following in your README. So this is what you have to use. So click on copy and README integration. What you have to do, you have to pay the things over here. So the domain that you copied, pay that. And Sahile, from name till API, whatever is it, so replace that with the domain. We do, and we replaced username.virtual.app. So you took that and did it. Now, for this particular thing, this username thingy, this is basically like when somebody clicks on that Spotify integration, they go to your profile directly. So from where you'll find this username, you go to Spotify. Then when you go to Spotify, you hit profile. I'm just like running this through really fast because this is something you can do on your own too. So when you click on account overview, you'll have your username over here. So you can take this username, copy it. And where is it? All right. So now what I'll do is I'll take this entire integration, copy it, and come back to my README. So where did I put Spotify? I don't know. There is too much. Yeah, here is Spotify. So as you can see that here I've already added the same link. Like it has my Spotify now playing and everything and my username as well. So after you've done doing this, you can, since like I did not make any changes, but you can obviously add a commit message. You can add update README with Spotify or something, and then you can commit the changes. So after you're done committing the changes, just like write a yes in this chat, please. After you've done pasting the thing. I'll wait till 5:10. No trouble there. Has anybody else done it? Are you facing any troubles? And also let me know. I'm stuck at refresh ID step. Okay. Banu, what step is it exactly? Can you like let me know? कौन से वाला मतलब curl command नहीं चल रहा है? You are not able to put in environment variables. After deployment, समय curl command is not working in Git. क्या दिक्कत आ रही है बानू? I'll answer Soumya till then. So Soumya, I think can you please repeat what you do after deploying? When you're done deploying, तो आपने overview देंगे, जहाँ पर आपके app deployed है, you'll just click on overview, then you'll click on, then you'll copy this domain. Okay, this domain is important. So copy this domain and paste it in your notepad. Then setup MD में there is going to be a link. You have to copy this. Then you have to replace username.virtual.app with the domain that you copied and your username by your Spotify username. So that's what you have to do. I got 404 error after deploying. Okay. Okay. So username is not mandatory, but what you can do is username jo hai wo Spotify jahan par like where your account is. Okay, go to spotify.com and click on profile and your account. So here your username will be visible. Okay, so that's what you have to copy. And then you have to copy the entire link in your README. Then you have to click on update README. Deployment में error. Okay, so like let's sort these errors at once. Like after you know we'll probably running it through and then closing the live stream and the recordings and everything. So I'll just like see what the errors are coming. So उसके बाद देखते हैं. ठीक है? It's showing authentication error. Git bash पे Git bash setup करा था कभी भानु? That could be the case. Anyway, so like what you have to do is that after you've done it, like it was the live to add that to your README, and then like if I just play, let's say I'm playing this, okay, playing, is it playing? Yeah, okay, it's playing. So then I'll just go to my README. So you can see that it's playing currently. So that's all you have to do. So at any point, if you were stuck or something, so you can come back to the setup guide and see. It has very clear instructions. I just like ran you through it. But still, you can see that. Now for the final part. The final part is this README generator. So this README generator is nothing like you can just like go here. So you go over here and then you can add your name or the title for you you're currently working on and everything. So you can add even skills so that it'll add like a jaise mere isme hai the languages and tools and everything connect with me. So that's something that you can do from here only directly. So zyada you don't have to work backend AI, ML, DB, DV, DevOps, sab kuch hai, every icon. So you can do that. Then you can add your socials and you can add these add-ons too. Then you can finally generate a README. So it will generate a README for you in under 1 minute. That's going to be looking very pretty. So this is the thing. Now I'll be sharing this presentation with you. And okay, I'll stop sharing. So here is the presentation. And I think now Vani Sanskriti, that's all that I had. We can probably stop the recording and you know the live stream now so that like I can take